Okay, let me recap from the beginning. Okay, I already explained to you last week about the marker type. Okay, marker detection process. How is the mark? Until marker detection. Okay, so how is the marker detection? This is the type of marker. Okay, many type of marker, and then how is the marker detection process from the beginning? This one there are image acquisition, pre-processing involved, and detection potential marker with whether accept or reject the marker, okay, and identify and decode the marker and calculate the marker pose. So this is the detail. How is the process of the detection of the marker so that your system, AR system, can able to display the virtual object, yeah, and of course on the top of your marker. So marker pose, we already discussed about the marker pose. Okay, refer to the coordinate and the location can be expressed with the three coordinate x, y, z. Okay, the distance between your camera to your marker. Okay, we also in order to speed up the marker detection, so this is the proper marker design so that you can achieve the fast, okay, detection, and also of course with the small data it can be computed faster. But anyway, currently if you have a good phone, currently we have a phone that with the minimum, I think, 1 megabyte memory, internal memory. As I know, the current phone is, they provide more than 1 megabyte. I think sometimes 1 gig memory, internal memory, not external. Yeah. We are talking about internal memory inside your phone so that it can help the system can perform faster in order to detect. Therefore, the number three here is not really relevant if you have a good performance, if you have a good devices, especially if you have a lot of memory, so the application can perform faster. So this one, number three, remember, if you have a good mobile device, so you can ignore number three. So next one, we will talk about the marker-based tracking. So you already did the marker-based tracking. This is lab two. You try to detect the marker. Okay, you know how the process of detection, marker detection, and then there are many type of marker. Yeah, marker detection. Another type here is a marker-based tracking. Okay, so what is a marker based here? Application use a camera and a visual marker. Okay, you did in the lab two. Okay. You have a visual marker. Okay, and then you have a camera, which is your mobile phone. Okay, to display the various object, you are able to display not only kitten, so you can replace, you can download the 3D model, free 3D model from the asset store, or you can make it by your own self. For example, I believe you already passed the 3D modeling, okay, and animation, so you can export it and then import into the Unity, then you can pop up. But usually in our course, we are using the established one. It means that we download from the asset store, and then we can modify the color. Okay, we can modify the prefab, so you can change the color. Of course, if you import the 3D models from the asset store, okay, it already established. Okay, it already done. And it ready to use. Okay. But you can change the color, but you can modify the 3D object, and also you can change the animation through the animator. So suppose if you look at the Unity, okay, there is a button behind, not behind, beside the scene game, and then another one is the animator. The next one is the animator. So this animator here is used to give a direction to animate your 3D object. Okay, if you look at the in the asset store, if you look at the, your asset, okay, you also can see the prefab. Inside the prefab, you provide you may provide the animation. For example, idle, okay, the kitten idle, and how is the animation going on? Maybe walk or maybe run, okay, run animation. So you will provide all of this thing, so you can use it to display the various object here, and determine the center orientation, okay, and the range of its spherical coordinate system, okay. And the QR code have found common use in the AR as a marker. Okay. QR code has been widely used as a marker, okay, because of remember, in the marker process, you have a certain hole, you have only two color, black and white, so it can process faster. Therefore, many user define the QR code as a marker. But you also can use your own marker, you can design your game, and maybe you can use a natural marker. It's possible, yeah. And the range, and the particularity, due to the fact that they are well suited for use where mobile devices are concerned. And the application will include the interactive 3D model and animation. Of course, when we scan the marker, we are going to show the 3D model and animation. Remember, should be interactive. Interactive means user able to control the 3D object, okay, over the system, okay. So the interactive means here you not only just pop up the 3D object, but you have to design as an interactive. So what happens if you press this joystick? Okay. Oh, the character move forward. Okay. Oh, backward. So you can control. So it there is an interactive between you and the system. So it can be augmented reality one. Otherwise, you just pop up or you just if just pop up and there is no interactive, so it will be useless. Yeah. So you have to make sure the 3D object that you display in your augmented reality should be interactive, okay. And then of course you need to add the animation. If you remember, if you create the 3D model in the 3D model and animation course, okay, you are able to create the 3D model. Okay, may I know how do you create the 3D model? Which software that you are going to use? Any one of you can answer my question? Hello?
3D model like cube or?
No. Have you taken the 3D model and animation subject or course?
Oh, no.
Oh, not yet. Anyone, others, student? Who has taken 3D model and animation?
No, sir, we didn't take it.
Oh, you didn't take it. Okay. But you can see that course in your list in the future, right?
I'm software, sir.
Oh, I see. Software, okay. But to those who BCG student, you may can see the another course that relate to the AR, so that you can create your 3D model based on your preference. Okay, you can create a 3D model and animate it. Usually we use Maya. Maybe for the other student, if you are interested, you also can enroll 3D modeling and animation in that is a graphic subject. So you can create your own 3D model. You can make the 3D model, for example, character Dragon Ball, or you can make a dragon. Okay, the dragon can show the fire, for example, many things. Yeah. So anyway, it's still related. Okay, but you to those maybe the student who are not a BCG, so you can import the 3D model from the asset store. Okay, you can find a free one. Yeah. Okay, this is the example augmented reality with a marker. Okay, if you look at this IKEA application, so do you know where is the 3D object?
The table.
And then where is the marker? Okay, where is the marker?
Is it the floor?
Maybe the floor, maybe the other thing, right? Something like you don't realize the marker, right? So this is a good thing. Is it natural? Is it a visual marker, or this is the shape marker, or is it the invisible marker? So as long as it will be a more natural, or maybe you the customer not aware about the marker, it will be good. Yeah, based on the perspective view, it will be better compare that you display the marker. But if you look at here, the marker here is the carpet one, so the floor one. You can see the there is a circle. Okay, that one is the marker one. And the table one is the 3D object. If you look at the 3D object, something like naturally display, isn't it? Something like if we just look at the just slightly see this image, okay, actually not really what you call notice, yeah, not really notice which the 3D object one, something like the table is also suitable. So we can imagine that, okay, it would be nice if we put the table here, so it can help for selling the item. So it has been used by IKEA, this application, so that the customer can imagine the location and also can rotate, can scale, can change the color. So you can add some feature in the application. Okay, so this is the example of the IKEA application. Another one is a markerless. Okay, markerless tracking. So that one is a marker based. Now is a markerless. Okay. In the markerless, active tracking and recognition of real environment on any type of support without using special place marker. So the key word here, without using special place marker. Okay. Example here of a recognition of the Lego book. Okay. If they can, you don't need to use a marker. Okay. Once you see the Lego box, it also can be display the what we call the 3D object and so on. And you also already did the markerless, which is lab 3, yeah, user defined target. Okay, that one is one of the markerless augmented reality. It means that you don't need the specific marker in order to display the 3D object. So you just try to find the ground plane. Okay, we call it ground plane. Once you detect yellow or green one, green means indicate the higher accuracy of your ground plane, so that you can press the the capture one, the capture button, then you can pop up the 3D object. So that one is markerless. So you don't need to use the marker. You just find the ground plane area, then you can display your 3D object. Okay. Markerless. Okay, this is some definition of the markerless here, where the intention of to present augmented reality is a particularly dynamic environment. So you can change into a different environment. Okay, you can display. You can display in many places, as long as you can detect the ground plane, such as while on the move, okay, outside, and so on. It is invisible that marker will be positioned on the majority of surrounding object. So you can walk around the, for example, you go to the Italy, for example, and then you can play the AR. If you remember Pokemon, okay, Pokemon also markerless. Okay, you don't need to use a marker. Once you get the certain position, it will appear the monster. Then you have to catch up the monster. So that one is also Pokemon has been famous. I think in the last 3 years, yeah, cannot mistake. So that one is one of the markerless, yeah. Okay. Consequently, yeah, in the majority of envision use case, yeah, where marker are unavailable and image recognition system is required. Okay. Image recognition system is required in order to detect your ground plane, or maybe you need to coordinate from the GPS location in order to display the 3D object. Okay, so marker are unavailable. Owing to the fact that the real world entity such as a human vehicle and a building present far greater complexity to the system than a simple 2D marker. Image recognition software require high processing power, of course. Yeah, if you use a markerless, it require high computational. Of course, only the specific device, and I believe now is the current device, mobile device, can support. Yeah, not like the 10 years ago. Okay, only they the memory very limited and so on. Okay. And here there are two type markerless. We call it passive and active. So what is the passive here? The user simply view AR through the suitable display where the camera is oriented way away from the user. View only mode, okay, where the user doesn't interact directly with the AR presentation. So we call it passive. For the active, the user is tracked by a camera and analyze the of this movement are translated to the image display. So what you did in the lab 3 user defined, it is one of the active markerless tracking. So the user is tracked by a camera, and an analysis of this movement are translated to the image display. Another one, okay, marker based, markerless. Okay, this is another one. Okay, the third one, which is location based tracking, okay, refers to the tracking based on geolocation information obtained from the device location sensor. We need the longitude, latitude, altitude, and compass bearing. Or something like accelerometer reading for pitch and roll. So you need a GPS. If your device doesn't have a GPS sensor, of course you are not able to get those information, and also you cannot display the 3D object. So the input here is the longitude, latitude, and altitude location. So the coordinate. Of course, you need the internet, yeah, data in order to track your current location. Something like in the iPhone, okay, iPhone, iPad, can there is application Finder, okay, so you can see where you go, okay, the location, right? So same like this one. Once you once you arrive in this location, in this coordinate, you are going to see the 3D object or maybe some information. If you look at here, you can see the Oxford Street. Okay, this is the, it means the user stand on that coordinate, on the certain coordinate, then you can view, you can the user can see some information, what we call virtual information, for example, banner and so on. And the location-based tracking is generally less accurate than optical method and only work in outdoor environment. We can say less accurate. Why less accurate, sir? What happen if you don't have internet connection? It means you don't have input. Once you don't have input, how can the augmented reality system can trigger those object? Cannot. Okay. Once the input, okay, and then what happen if your GPS sensor is giving a wrong coordinate? Of course, it also can affect. Okay, remember the input here is the coordinate of longitude, latitude, and altitude. In order to obtain, in order to display the virtual one. Okay, so next is a we call it Google Glass Travel Guide. Google launched these devices. So something like Glass, okay, you can use it, and they embedded the augmented reality inside the glass. So if you can see the real, and also when you press this button, and then you can see the virtual one. When you go around the world, okay, the Google, actually they also use the Google Map, okay, Google Map to track and then to give input the location. Okay, then it will show the, for example, you also can take a picture. It also can give you example, give you information about the what we call the city, restaurant, hotel, and price. It can link to Agoda. And so on. So this is a Google Glass travel guide. Okay, object registered in 3D. Regression, this is the process, object registered in the 3D object here, positioning a virtual object with regard to the real world. Continually locating the user viewpoint, okay, and position and orientation. Of course, if you are register the 3D object and then you are trying to upload the 3D object, once you arrive in the certain location, into a certain position, and the virtual object will be appear into the certain position, only those in those coordinate will be a display. So another one is a tracking. This one is a tracking. Let's us discuss about the tracking. Okay, in the tracking technology, there are two type, which is active or passive. Okay, for the active, you need the mechanical. This example is a mechanical, magnetic, and ultrasonic, GPS, Wi-Fi, and cell location. And my student already did this one, the active one. So they use the what we call the GPS as input to give a direction. Wait a moment. And another type is a passive. Okay, passive here is a inertial sensor, for example, compass, okay, accelerometer or gyro. And another one is the computer vision. For example, is marker-based, natural feature tracking, so we call it passive. So something like this is not real time. Okay, for active you need real time data input. So that we can say the active is the active tracking as a marker is less accurate because there it involves the internet access. What happened if you don't have a signal? So it will affect to your current location, current coordinate, and so on. For the passive, no, this is something like compass. Okay, it already something like Google Map. You are trying to export Google Map. Okay, but once the Google Map has been updated, your application cannot detect the updated one. So active and passive. Another one is a hybrid, which is a combined sensor. For example, vision and inertial. This is the example. Okay, if we talk about the tracking type, there are many of tracking, magnetic tracker, inertial tracker, ultrasonic tracker, optical tracker, and mechanical tracker. But now we are going to discuss about optical tracker, which is can be three categorized. First is specialized tracking. Okay, you have a specialized tracking. So if you have a certain pattern here, you can display display the arrow or 3D object. Okay. Second one is a marker based tracking. It means that you have to provide a marker, a visual marker. Okay. Another one is a markerless tracking. Okay. So without marker or without visible marker. Okay. If we talk about the markerless tracking, there are three. Okay. There are three component here. We call it. It can based on the edge-based tracking, based on the edge, something, edge, we call it edge. If you look at the, for example, if we can see the edge pattern or form, okay, or the form is, for example, is a triangle, and then the opposite of triangle is a cube, for example. So the triangle and cube has an edge. So it can consider as can be used as a marker, the edge of the item or the edge of the object. Okay. Next one is the template based tracking. Another one is interest point tracking. So let us discuss in detail one by one. Okay. Example here, marker tracking. It is already available for more than 10 years. So this technology is not new. It's already common. And there are several open source such as AR Toolkit, okay, AR Tech, and ATK Plus, and etc. One of my students already explored the AR Toolkit for her PSM. And then it is fairly simple to implement a standard computer vision method, and a rectangle provide four corner point enough for pose estimation. Okay, let me show it to you. I will share it. Okay, AR Toolkit. What is AR Toolkit, sir? For example, here it is a software, a library for building augmented reality application. So something like API. So you can use the feature inside the AR API in order to, for example, track your position. Possible, yeah. And then this application involves the overlay of virtual imagery on the real world. For example, the image to the right here. The three-dimensional virtual character appears standing on the real car. And then it can be seen by the user in the headset display they are wearing. When the user moves the car, the virtual character moves with it, and appear attached to the real world. Okay, and then AR toolkit here. Okay, something like it is a non virtual camera can be positioned at the same point, and the 3D computer graphic model draw exactly overlaid on the real marker. So it can help you for viewpoint tracking and the virtual object interaction. If you want to make interaction within your 3D object and your what we call the 3D object and the user, for example, you display the 3D object. Okay, once you toss the 3D object, it can interact. Something like it can run. Before this, you use a joystick, right? But it can be happen like that. Let me share it to you. Another example of AR toolkit. This is my student. She developed the. Let me show it to you. Her thesis. She made the Armon. Okay, Armon, which is it is something like what we call show the direction. Okay, because the UMP is very big area, very big land. So if you want to go to a library, for example, and then you can open this application, then it can give the direction where is the shortest path, yeah, to arrive on that destination. So her name is, I forgot the name. I think this is Jolene. Okay, her name is Jolene. Okay, this is my student. So this is the example of implementation of AR toolkit. So remember, AR toolkit is the library. They provide some feature, then you can utilize this feature in order to track your location. So one of the markerless application. If you look at here, this is the example. Where is it? Let me see the result. Okay, this one. Okay, you can open the camera, you can navigate. Once you navigate, you can get something like create a waypoint. Okay, so something like you pin your location. Okay, you pin your location. Okay, and then you also can see all the map list we need to upload into the system. Okay, the map, you can use the your current map, and then you can after that you can search into the, for example, library. Yeah, okay, of course, not suddenly can detect the library, so you need to something like training, something like you need to pin from the beginning, from the start, and then also the destination, need on two. Okay, after that you save into database. If you want to reuse that path, okay, you only need to pin your current location. Okay, but at the beginning you need to save the start point to and the finish point. Okay, and then you save it into a library. So they will know, okay, this is this track is going to library. Okay, and then when you open a new application, it will be tracked. Okay, where is your current position? If your current position in the line of this path, it will show it to you like this. It will show it to you the way. Okay, the green arrow show the direction where you go to. This one is Astaka building. Okay, and then it can navigate. This is the 3D arrow is 3D object. There is animation, something like bling bling bling. So left, you can go to right. So this is this project utilize the AR toolkit. Okay. So this one is simple. Okay. This is just test. That's it. And actually, there is a video. Yeah. I asked her to make a video, and then when presentation, so can display, because this is one of the sample of AR toolkit. Very nice. So you may to test and to try to use this one. Okay, next one. So this is the example. Okay, this is the process of AR toolkit. You can access the AR toolkit, the library of AR toolkit, and then import it into the Unity. So you can access through artoolkit.sourceforge.net. So you can get the definition, you can get the process, how it is work, and then you also can, they also provide the sample, how to utilize, how to explore it. So let me explain a little bit the process of AR toolkit here. It is a common library that we use. Same like you are going to use a user-defined target, okay? You also use the that library, okay, in order to track. So you don't design from the beginning, but you use the library to you utilize the library to support your system. So the process here, first video stream from the camera, and then you search for the marker. The image is converted to the binary image, black and white marker frame. It is going to identify how many hole, how many fast rejection, okay, and then find the three marker 3D position and orientation, okay, position and orientation of the mark. Okay. After that, identify the marker. Okay, the symbol inside the marker is matched with the template in the memory. Then you pop up, push, and then using T Transform 3D virtual object to align them with the marker, okay, position orientation. And finally render the 3D object in the video frame, so you can see the 3D object. Another one is this library also provide the what we call tracking, yeah, the tracking one, the GPS one. Okay? You may provide the longitude, latitude, coordinate in order to identify your current location, then you can find your destination. So this is a very powerful. There are many library inside this one. You also can explore in detail. Okay, it's about the marker based tracking AR toolkit. Okay, this is the example. Another example here. There is a occultation. Okay, unfocused camera, a motion blur. So AR toolkit also can solve this solution. Okay, what happen if your marker has occultation like this? There is a small rectangle here, or maybe you have a blur marker your camera because of camera lens is not really nice, so that you produce a blur video. Yes, it still can perform by using AR toolkit. AR toolkit can filter your marker, can adjust your marker sense so that it can identify your marker. And the next one is a dark lit scene. Okay, what happen if you have a dark condition? It also can perform by using AR toolkit. It can helpful. Okay, let me stop first.
Asyhadu an la ilaha illallah. Asyhadu an la ilaha illallah. Asyhadu an Muhammad Rasulullah.
Okay, let us continue. And AR toolkit also can be used for to avoid the Photoshop illustration, okay, and false positive and intermarker confusion. Okay, for example, this one in the keyboard here, we also can see, okay, the marker of V represent a robot, okay, from robot number 4, something like a short key. So something like you, by using the AR toolkit, we can get something like multiple marker. Okay, once the user want to for example press a V, so it indicates the user want to call robot 3 and so on. So this is something like it can help, very useful, yeah, and image noise, yeah, or poor lens and block coding. So no more marker. If we talk about the markerless, we don't need the marker in order to display the 3D object. So you can use interest point tracking. Interest point tracking is for example, user define. Okay, you may pop up the 3D object based on your interest point, the point that you touch. You also can, for example, I want to display in this area, then I touch this area, so it will be happen. Okay, not only detect the ground floor, but it's also possible to display into interest point. Once the user into the touch into the certain coordinate, it also can be pop up. Okay. So remember, in the markerless, there are example. For example, here is the edge-based tracking, template-based tracking, and interest point tracking. So let us see, for example, edge here. This is the natural feature tracking. Okay, use the natural cues of real elements, yeah, such as edge, surface texture, interest point, and the model, or the model free on, and then no visual pollution. Yeah, this is the example. Okay, the feature point, if you look at this building, the contour of the object, okay, and the surface of the object, and the feature point, the something like the edge of the object, okay, can be your marker, and then you can display this 3D object, okay, the yellow one, the 3D object one. It because of the camera able to detect the contour of the or the surface of the object. And then another one is a texture tracking. Okay, texture. For example, if you open certain text, okay, and those text indicate, of course, the text indicate the something like edge, right? Something like a pattern, right? Those text can be your marker. Okay, for example, S. Okay, the texture of the S like this. Okay, A like this. Okay, triangle. Okay, and then I. Oh, I is only the vertical. So the edge of the each character can be used as a marker, so we can call it texture tracking. Of course, we have to the camera should be capture those text, yeah. Otherwise, it cannot pop up. Here, maybe you can see. Oh, maybe the markup is the emitter. Okay, no, this one is the in the texture one. Okay, once the text is detected, okay, then it display the 3D object so that the user should capture closely, yeah, to the texture. Otherwise, cannot be detect. Okay, this is another example. Edge based tracking. You can see this is the edge. Okay. The white the right side you can see the white line here is the edge, and this edge is used as the marker. This is the line based tracking. Okay, if we look at here, there are several shape. Okay, the tracking. Okay, there is a rectangle and there is a form like this, the track like this. Then it can be display the 3D object. If you have a track like that, so it can be used as a marker in order to display the red car here. If you don't meet this tracking, the track of the red one is the track, yeah. So that one is the shape. So it will be display the red car. What happen if you remove? Okay. One item on the top of this object, it will not display because the line tracking it will be different. So this is example. Okay, another one is a model based tracking. Okay, once you detect the model, okay, the model here is the something like the edge that have a model or something like yeah, we call it model. The shape like that. Okay, the model. If you look at the purple one here. Okay, so it will be appear the 3D object. Okay, so face tracking, by using a face tracking, we can display. Of course, this one you can use the OpenTL. OpenTL also one of the library. Okay, so this library for the purpose of this library to model based visual tracking. Okay, once you have this model, it will appear the 3D object. Example, you have a design of house, for example, for the architecture. Okay, once you display the architecture design, it will be appear the building. Okay, or the building, or there are two floor and then there is many furniture, so it can help to market their property. So you can use the OpenTL instead that what we call IR toolkit. So OpenTL focused on the model. So if you are going to display a marker as a model, so you can use OpenTL.org here. Okay. Okay, this is another one, control navigation, face tracking, and so on. Okay, so what's the advantage and disadvantage between marker and natural feature tracking? Okay, marker and natural feature. For marker, the advantage is marker can be eye catcher. Of course, if you don't have marker, we cannot display the 3D object. So that the marker should be visualized. Okay, the another advantage is tracking is less demanding. Okay, you don't need to track because you already see the track, the marker. Then if you want to display the 3D object, you have to capture the 3D object. So that one is the advantage. The disadvantage, the environment must be instrumented with the marker, and the marker usually work only when fully in view. If your marker capture only half, of course you cannot see the 3D. So the 3D can be displayed if they can capture fully marker. Yeah. How about the natural feature tracking? Okay. The disadvantage here is that a database of key point must be stored or downloaded. If you have what we call natural feature here, for example, magazine, yeah, the cover of magazine. Maybe you are not realize that that one is the natural feature tracking, for example, or maybe the natural here, for example, the outdoor one. Let's say you capture 2, 3, for example, there are three, okay, both three has a specific green, so that you try to capture those three, okay, and will be used as your marker. So the most important, you need to store those three. What happened if three is a burn, for example? So you lost the marker, you cannot display the 3D object again. And the advantage, the natural feature target might catch the attention less. Human cannot realize those three are the marker. Oh, maybe the building, the Faculty of Computing building. Oh, as a marker, is it possible? Yes, possible. As the natural, sometimes, oh, this is a natural one, but we don't realize that it is the marker. And another advantage is natural feature target are potential everywhere. Huh? It can be everywhere. Everyone, everywhere can be your marker, but you need to store into the your system, into your AR application. Another advantage is the natural feature target work also in partially in view. Okay. So this is the another example in the outdoor hybrid tracking. Okay, it's a combination between the computer feature, okay, and inertial gyroscope sensor. If you can see here, there is dot 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 dot. Okay, how many pattern here dot? Okay, so and also the natural tracking here. How many three? One, two, three. And one more is the taller building. Okay, how many feature? So both condition by in order to display the 3D object. If okay, what happen if the point here marker point is lost? One lost, for example, so it cannot be display. Yeah, both correct for each other. So you need this is combination between the natural and also the a certain point of interest here. Okay, how about the others here? A robust outdoor tracking. Okay, for example, hybrid tracking. Okay, you can combine between a computer vision and the GPS location. Okay, for example here, this is the building. Okay, as your marker. But at the same time, you also combine with the location. So not only one. So you make it condition. If the building shape like the feature, or your current location, or you can make it condition N. If condition N, both conditions should be true, then you can pop up the 3D object. Or you can make it or means if the location accepted or if the location true, then pop up. If you meet the same building pattern, if you meet the same building shape, so it will be pop up. So there are two. Yeah, hybrid here you can make a certain condition. You can use and or you can use or. Okay. It can combine between the GPS, your location, and also the computer vision, the shape of the pattern or the edge of the building here. Okay, when to use a marker-based tracking? Okay. Tracking in environment that are challenging for a feature tracking. Acquiring the correct scale and convenience coordinate frame. Environment with a lot of moving object and occlusion. If you have many movement object, for example, you are in the road and then you are trying to use a markerless, that one is wrong. Okay, if your environment has many vehicle movement, so you need to use marker base. For example, sign road become your marker. Okay. Don't use markerless, otherwise it cannot be detected due to vehicle movement. This is the something like not problem, yeah, something like obstacle. And need for extra information. If you want to display the extra information, for example, this information can link to another one. Link, you have a sub information, so you need the marker base. Hybrid method, environment with the existing marker, device with the limited computational capacity and memory, so you need the marker. So let's say your handphone is low with the low spec, then you have to use a marker base. Don't use markerless because your handphone does not support. As I remember, one of the student in my class, their handphone cannot detect the markerless because of the devices not support. So you may upgrade the devices, then you can use the markerless. If you have a low spec, so you have to use the marker base. And then when you need interaction with the user, okay, usually if you use a marker base, you need to involve interaction. For example, when I touch this one, the 3D object can sing a song, something like in the book for the children. Okay, for example, when we click this one, the system can trigger something. So you need the marker base. If you use a markerless, okay, usually it does a passive. Passive means sometimes we can interact, but not too much. Usually it is a passive. For example, I go to this place, I can see there is a hotel. That's it. How can you interact to the hotel unless you have a Google Glass or maybe you have a special device, then you can interact. But if you want to focus on interaction, so you need to use marker base. Something like touching the 3D object, and then the object will dance and so on. Yeah. And the indication of the existence of the virtual data. I think that's it. Any question regarding to the location-based AR? Then I open question now.
No, sir.
Are you interested to build AR tracker?
No.
Yes, Ruby, you want to say something? I didn't listen what you say. Anyone who interested developing the augmented reality, for example, this one, navigation panel, this is something like show the location. Anyone of you interested using AR toolkit?
Yes, it looks very interesting and useful.
Yeah, but however, maybe the implementation will be so difficult. Maybe it will take 1 month for me.
Actually, not really difficult. But because you are at the first beginning, something like don't say that it is impossible, but you have to try. I have a question from Nur Alia. Salam, sir. Is there a quiz tomorrow? It is including our section. Yes. I don't inform it to you that we have a quizzes tomorrow. So you may to prepare. Let me check. Of course, This time 20%, 3%. Okay, tomorrow 8 to 12 PM. Oh, the whole day. This is online quiz. It's about chapter 1 and chapter 1, 2, 3. Yeah. So we just complete chapter 2. Okay. We just complete the chapter 2. Let me check. Can we proceed to chapter 3? Is it okay?
Okay, sir. Maybe you can pray and then we can come back.
Okay. Should we fast? I don't think so. Cannot fast. Let me inform you regarding to the quiz one. I have to check whether it covered chapter 3 or not, but obviously I already delivered chapter 1 to chapter 3, okay, and this is the Wikitude. I don't explain yet, so let me check first, okay, for the quiz 1. Okay, it's not cannot fast. I explain this one, so better I maintain next week, but it's still general, this one. Let me go through until slide number 9, so 8 slide. So in this course, the learning outcome here to understand the production pipeline, okay? In a producing AR product, which consists of pre-production, production, and post, okay? In order to develop AR, you need to, there are three steps: pre, product, and post. Okay? This is the outline. So talking about the pre-production, how can we quickly prototype mobile AR experience with a little or no coding? If you refer to AR, okay, sometimes you can develop AR without coding, without C# application. Okay. Sometimes you need the C# in order to control the 3D object, isn't it? So sometimes you need the coding, sometimes no. If you need the if you don't need to coding, something like you display the 3D object and then you also can make animation, okay, something like can give a telling story from to the children, for example, or maybe once we pop up and then we display what we call maybe the 3D object sing a song, okay, that one is no need to coding, just drag and drop and display it. Okay, and then if you need a coding, something like you are going to control the 3D object. Okay, for example, you want to show the weapon of the 3D object. Okay, so fire. Then you need to control using a joystick. Of course, you need specific using a C# code. Okay. The why you need to prototype, okay, it is a quick visual design, capture key interaction, focus on the user experience, and communicate design idea and learn by doing experience. So when you talk about the augmented reality, you must conduct prototype, you must develop the prototype, otherwise you don't know how to visual design, how to design the kitten, for example, is it should be bigger or should be small? and capture a key interaction. How do you interact to the kitten, for example? Oh, you are going to use a joystick, maybe. Focus on the user experience. Okay. User experience, usually kitten walk in the land. Why you display the what we call the pop-up, the 3D model in water, for example, and the 3D object is a animal, for example, it's not suitable. Suppose in water, you display the fish and so on. So focus on the user experience, okay? And make sure the 3D object that you create is suitable with the user experience, okay? Something like you pop up in the suitable way. Okay? Don't pop up, okay? When I capture in the faculty computing building, and then suddenly display a fish. So there is no relevance. Something like relevancy here is as a user experience. And communicate a design idea. When you design your augmented reality, should be comes from the idea. The idea should be translated into the design. First, we want to use a kitten walk in this area, and then the kitten can eat some, for example, can drink the milk, for example. So you design the milk here, and this should be a marker based, or this application should be markerless. This one should be tracking. So you need to design it. How do you communicate a design idea? Okay, you are going to develop, for example, AR destination. Oh, just now my student is what you call Mac Pro, not Mac Pro. I forgot the name. Something like you are trying to arrive into a certain destination. Suppose you use the markerless. Okay, don't try to use marker based. So something like your design translating the idea into the design should be proper, and learn by doing or experience. So it is the reason why you need to prototype your AR. For the design or prototyping tools here, we call it low fidelity and high fidelity. There is a range between designing or prototyping tools. For example, low fidelity, something like you are sketching. Okay, you sketch. You sketch something like you are draw into the paper, okay, the system should going like that, should going like this, for example. Or there is a kitten and there is a joystick, so user can ask the kitten to move. So sketch, not include the UI, something like still sketching, you draw. Okay. And then if we go to the high fidelity, it is the functional prototype. It means that you already designed the joystick color. You have already think about the color. How about the what we call the size of the joystick? What happened if the application installed into different screen size can be adjustable or not? Or the joystick can be moved 100%, for example, or you limit into 25% area. So you are that one is, we call it functional prototype, and it can be function. So you design high, we can call it high fidelity design. Okay, this is the we call it type of a designing. There are sketching, prototype, design studio, wireframing, and finally, if you go to the right side, which is a prototype or functional prototype, that one is the highly fidelity. Okay, if you look at the prototyping tools, there are many way. For example, for low fidelity, sketching, user interface template. Storyboard is also low fidelity. Storyboard here is, for example, you have a scene, a activity, then you are talking the activity inside this, you are describing the activity inside that scene. So we call it storyboard. Okay, and storyboard here also show the flow of the application, flow of the AR game. Okay, user shoot fire, for example, so that the character can show the weapon and fire, for example. And the second scene, okay, character should find the credit, for example. So something like you are telling the activity inside the scene, that we call it storyboard, okay, and screen sharing and so on. For the interactive or high fidelity, usually we call it wireframing tool, okay, or mobile prototyping or native coding. Mobile prototyping, you can use it. Adobe XD in order to prototype how it looks like the end of the product, okay, and the 3D object. Not only the 3D object should be appear as the 3D object that you want. Okay, this is the typical development step. Usually start from sketching, storyboard, UI mockup, okay, interaction flow, video prototype, interactive prototype, and finally final native application. So when you increase the fidelity, it means that the design should be something like the readiness is high. So something already you already design about the color and so on. So that one is the final one. Okay, if we talk about the low fidelity tools here, this is the example sketching UI template storyboard, and then just in mind here processing. This is the example of the high fidelity. This is low fidelity. Let me repeat again. Low fidelity, for example, sketching, UI template, storyboard, glassware, flow designer, and Android design preview. You can also type this one, Android design preview. So you can see how do you sketch your Android design. For the high fidelity, you can use just in mind, you can use a weird script, you can use AR browser, or the Unity 3D. Okay. That one is the, as we know that you are currently using a Unity 3D, right? So once you drag the 3D, already have a color, already have the shape, and so on. So that one is the high fidelity tool. So sketch interface, this is the sketch plus a PowerPoint, and this is the example, if you want to, example of the sketch on the left side, and the right side is the high fidelity or the end of the product, the expected of the design. Okay, you design, this is the example, the design on the left, something like start from the scratch, okay, using your pen, your pencil, okay, and the right side is a high fidelity. So this is the sample of sketch, and this one is a user interface design. Okay, paper prototyping, okay, this is when you first time, okay, when you design the application, okay, you may to design the prototype into the paper. Okay, how many button you have, what kind of feature you have in your system. Like my student, for example, at the beginning there is a logo, there is a login, there is some option. So you need to design at the beginning. After that, paper prototyping, software or hardware. Okay, so you need to use the software and the hardware involved here, and a storyboard. Okay, it is a sequence of sketch showing use a system in the everyday use context and concrete the example easier or faster to grasp than text-based story compared to you are telling the story through written, okay, you need to visualize into the storyboard. Okay, means the communication with the user and system development. How do you interact? So you can write into the activity, and also you need to illustrate it. Usually, if you write the storyboard, you design your interface, then in the bottom, you discuss the activity. Sketch and not drawing. If you talk about the storyboard, it is not drawing, but it is a sketch. Yeah. Use the task interaction and make sure design work. Oh, this is the example storyboard, okay, number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. For example, welcome screen. Okay. Then the system suggests whatever. And third one, activity, what the kind of activity, 4, 5, and so on. In the AR, we can create a multiple scene. Yeah, we can create a multiple scene. We can go to another scene, like same like as a game application. Okay, this is the example of a storyboard presentation. Usually, you sketch your activity in the visual, in visualize, and then you describe in the bottom. Okay. How the user start the system at the beginning until end of the activity. And this is the another example of a storyboard. Okay. Okay, next one is a wireframe and mock-up. Okay. After you conduct the storyboard, you need to come out with the wireframe. Okay. Roughly sketch a sequence exploring and validating interaction design. Focus is on navigation and functionality. How do you navigate, okay, the character? How do you navigate the scene? Okay, if you want to go to another scene, and usually explore one interaction, but can also be used as the foundation for development of testing prototype. So this is the example. So this is the example of the mock-up. Okay. So you are designing, you are sketch the screen of your mobile device. Okay, in this part, okay, this is image, okay. But you don't put the image, the true image, yeah, here. Something like you just draw a box. Okay, then there is a person. Okay, a blur person, because this is the still low fidelity prototyping. So you don't display the picture, the real picture in this mock-up here. Yeah, mock-up here, something like you are make sure what kind of what we call interaction design. Okay, how do you navigate, how the system provide navigation between user and system. For example, there are three tags here, the next scene supposed like this. So this is the example of for mock-up, yeah. Okay, how about the high fidelity prototyping? Okay, need to clean up and pretty much should be done here. State A from the mock-up, and then you translate transition into the state B. This is the example. Okay, and this is the visualize of the expected user interface, your design. If the AR, for example, if I can see, it can display the temperature, for example, this is the augmented, the virtual one that we want to display. Or maybe you are going to show the map like this, or maybe something like what we call leave the misses here, or you are going to provide some feature, for example, calendar, Google, and so on. Limitation here, the positive one, good for documenting a screen, can show the application flow. And the negative one, no interactivity or transition, and cannot be used for testing, cannot deploy on wearable, and can be time consuming to create. This is the example, interactive wireframing. developing interactive interface or wireframe, transition, user feedback, and interface design. So you can use a proto.io in order to design your interface, or you can use UX pin. Okay. For the native tool, you can use a just in mind. Okay. You can access through here or Azure in order to design your frame. Oh, this one example. Pop application dot in here a combining sketching and interactivity on mobile. Take picture of sketch and link picture together. This is the example. So this is a low fidelity. Okay, you can use a pop application in dot in. Yeah. So this is how we design the augmented reality application. Yeah. Suppose there is a introduction part, then goes to the next frame and so on. Okay, the using a pop application in, you can organize your wireframe, make it interactive in 60 seconds, simulate on your iPhone and share publicly or privately with a friend. So you can design it using you also can use the proto.io here. This is a web-based mobile prototype tool. Prototype for multiple device, gesture input, touch event, animation, and share with the collaborator and test on device. So the proto.io here, if you look at the detail, you can access through the website here. So there is a circle, rectangle, and so on in order to design your interface. How about the Android design preview? Okay, you can. It is a mirror portion of the desktop to Android device and work with the Google Glass and other Android wearable. Okay, same purpose but different feature here. For the interactive wireframe limitation, cannot deploy on device. No access to sensor data. Okay, no multimedia playback, and simple transition and no networking. Okay, for advanced prototyping tools, in order to make it something like a prototype, small, powerful prototype, you can use existing application. I will show it to you later on. And you can use AR browser. What is AR browser? AR browser here is used to display the 3D object. Is it same like the what we call Vuvoria? Yes, definitely. It's look like Vuvoria, but you have another platform. Vuvoria is a free one, but if you can see on the left side bottom, okay, you can see marker which is Vuvoria. Trademark, you can see the trademark of Vuvoria. But if you purchase the Vuvoria, it will be disappear. So you, it will be show developed by Unity. After that, there is no Vuvoria. If you aware about the your screen, yeah. Same like AR browser. Okay, AR browser here, they have some library such as Wikitude, Layar, Orasma. So you can replace the Vuvoria by using AR browser. Instead of Vuvoria, you can use AR browser. It also powerful. It has a what we call a specific feature. For example, image recognition. Okay. Image recognition can be your marker. Yes, it can true. For example, you go to the, for example, you go to the faculty computer building. You can recognize a certain feature. This one is a more powerful. Maybe we will discuss later in detail But I'm going to give you an assignment using AR browser so that you are not only can use the Vuvoria, but you are able to use AR browser. So at least both. Yeah. There are many feature, for example, Wikitude, Layar, Aurasma, and so on. And the last, another one is a rapid development platform. You can use processing.org or phonegap.com. Okay, this is the interactive design process. Usually we design, okay, then we conduct a prototype and then we evaluate. Functionality, view option, camera, map view, list view, and sub option, place or event or restaurant. Okay, so it can be your sub option, okay. And an AR feature, for example, you can provide a text information, you can provide a 3D object, you can provide the 3D tour guide, okay, and 3D placement of building. So there are many feature here. Maybe you have to select the suitable for you. Okay. For the view option, you can use camera as usual, using camera to capture the marker. Okay. Or you use a map. Okay, in order to view, can be use your marker and many thing, yeah, list view and so on. So this is example of storyboard. Okay, so you need to draw the activity and you need to discuss the activity on the bottom. No, yeah, on the bottom. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is sequence, yeah. Sequence. It show the flow. After I complete this one, the system will pop up the second scene, and the third scene will talk about this one, and so on. So I believe this is another storyboard. Okay, once I click, for example, kids here, it goes to here, second scene. Then you discuss here, describe, explain it here. When I click this one, it goes to this frame. This frame will display a house, for example. So it will be discussed. When the user click this left button, it show blah, 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 blah. So we call it storyboard. Okay. Let's say once the 3D object, once you click this one, it show the beep, for example. So you can explain. Maybe this is a display, a video, for example, make it faster, pause, play and pause, and so on. If you click this one, art, for example, display the picture, okay, and so on. Oh, if we click this one, maybe there is an animation involved in your activity, so you need to discuss. Okay, I think let me stop until interactive here. Oh, almost 10 slides more. Is it okay for you if I continue?
Yes, sir, it's okay.
10 slides more. Next one is interactive. in the interactive design process, you need to remember in the previous one, we have low fidelity and high fidelity. Okay, sketch, and for the high fidelity, which is a Wikitude. So this is the initial sketch, okay, initial sketch. There is a house, okay. When I capture this house, this is means natural image, okay. It will be pop up the information, text information like this. There is a map, list, okay, and 3 button, okay. Good for the idea generation, and it is very cheap, and the concept seem feasible. So this is the initial step. When you create the application, you must follow the sketch. After that, you design the mock-up. Finally, you can conduct the prototype with the functionality from the low fidelity until the high fidelity. Okay. Sometimes when you try to start with the high fidelity, sometimes you are missing some feature. Therefore, you need to start from the sketch. Yeah. Okay, next constraint here, not great feedback gain, and the Photoshop not fast enough for making things. Okay. Not great feedback gain. Of course, you cannot give it to the user because it's still sketch. Sketch still something like idea. If you want to add on, if you want to remove the feature, this is the happen in this test. Yeah. So before you develop the application, you have to sketch first. You have to think, okay, what happened if a user press this button? What kind of features should be involved in this button? So you need to try to what we call thinking about the what happened if the what kind of feature should be involved in inside the button and so on. So this is a post-it prototyping, okay. Camera view 3D, okay, this is 3D object, okay. And this is the first draft, second draft, and the third draft. The second draft selection highlight in the blue, oh, okay. It means that once the user press this button, it will be changed the color blue. Okay. And the third draft, home button edit for easy navigation to main menu. Okay, so it show the process step by step. Okay, when you design the AR. Okay, this is the, we can call it the sketch and post-it prototyping means from the sketch you try to make it a prototype, but still in the sketch. You can something like you make it what we call initiate the color here. What happened if the user click this button? What kind of interaction involved in the system? Oh, the interaction here change the color. Okay, and this one home button edit for easy navigation. So you need the home button or the symbol should be home button. So from beginning. Then you try to refining from time to time so that you can get the result like this. This is a 3D object. Okay, when we click this one, 3D object, it will be appear the 3D object. So this is a place, event, food, okay, and so on. Benefit, used for user testing, interactive, functionality work, and very quick. Okay. And easy arrangement of slide, so you can easily arrange from one scene to another scene. So and is it can be used for the testing, okay? And the user testing participant found 15 minute session screen capture. So you need to test, okay? Allow technique use and not taken. Post interview. So when you design, you need to something like you need to test your design to the stakeholder or the participant. You can talk about the technique that you use in the system, what is going on this scene, second scene, and so on, and then you will get the feedback from the user for your input. So this is the flow. I hope you don't design by yourself, but you also try to get the feedback from the other people. And then for the next slide, it is a Wikitude. Okay, as I explained before, Wikitude as a popular AR browser instead of Vuforia. Currently, you are using Vuforia, but next 2 weeks, we are trying to use a Wikitude. Mapping, okay. This is a feature inside the Wikitude, a point of interest ability, multi-platform, and show the point of interest. Marker can be selected in, and information pop-up appear. Let me show it to you. Okay, maybe you have a question. Is it free, sir? Yes, this is free. However, there is a trademark diagonal mark. It show you we call it wikitude, something like that. So in order to remove the copyright or not copyright, the visible copyright, so you can purchase, but it is free. Same like the Vuvoria. Is it more powerful compared to Vuvoria? Yes. The Wikitude provide a better feature than Vuvoria, but the Vuvoria is very popular due to the copyright on the bottom. You know, sometimes if we make a AR application, and then you can see the trademark or something like a copyright, visible copyright, it will be annoying, right? So that Vuvoria is more popular because the copyright is on the bottom left side, so it doesn't annoying, it doesn't affect to the visual. But if in the Wikitude, it will be a diagonal in the center one, okay? And Wikitude is more powerful than the Vuvoria. It has a image recognition. You can see multiple player. You can create your what we call the 3D object. You can, and then you can fire to another multiple player, and then you can get the point. So this is very powerful. I already asked my student to develop the Wikitude for the last year. Okay, and yes. It is free, and then we will try again to use the Wikitude. However, the result, there is a mark diagonal unless you purchase. Yeah, okay. For the Wikitude, here is the user testing application well received, understandable, and participant playful with the technology, and this is the final design concept here. Fixed issue found in the previous session, designed with the guideline in mind, appealing with the mental model, okay, and aesthetic design, color, font, button, and looks. So this is a markerless, okay. It show the flexibility tools for capturing the use of an interface, elaborate a simulation of how the navigational aid will work. It doesn't need to be realistic in the every detail, and give a good idea of how the finished system will work. So this is the example how to design our AR application here. This is the end of the prototype. Okay, I think that's it. Any question? Let me open. One, almost 2 p.m. Two chapter, one and a half chapter. Okay, good. I hope you have a good internet connection to. So the color is quiz tomorrow. Is it include our session? Yes. It is online quiz, so you can open book, but you have limited time. Okay, any question? General question, something like if you read the chapter 1, 2, 3, then the storyboard, what's the purpose of our storyboard? Okay. Then you can answer it. I think there is multiple choice, something like multiple choice. Open question. This week, I don't what we call. Upload the video, yeah, not yet, yeah, because I inform many training, but I hope on Saturday I try to upload for multiple marker. Any question?
No, sir.
Okay, yeah. Good luck for your quiz. Good luck for your quiz tomorrow. Thank you so much. I hope you have a good days, and please recap again our lecture today, and I hope it can help you to for answer the quiz multiple choice. And You can open book. Okay. Thank you so much. See you next week.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.